Welcome to the Cybersecurity Evaluation Tool, or CSET. This tool was developed by the United States Department of Homeland Security. It provides a systematic and repeatable process for critical infrastructure asset owners to assess and improve the cybersecurity posture of industrial control systems and information networks. In this tutorial, we will walk through each step of the process as if we were performing an assessment from scratch. Not all functions will be covered, but hopefully you will get a taste of how the system works. We form a team of control system engineers, network administrators, IT specialists, cybersecurity staff and managers, then begin the evaluation. Let's jump right in and create a new assessment. We want to make sure we capture information about the assessment for both the reports and for future reference. We will enter each field. However, we plan to come back and update the executive summary field after the assessment is complete. To navigate in CSET, we can either use the buttons at the top of the screen or the Next button on the bottom. We will click on the Next button to select our approach and standards. We aren't sure which option to choose, so we click on the question mark icon on the bar and review the help information. We also take a few minutes to watch the video. We are planning a NERC-SIP assessment in several months, and at that time, we will come back and choose the requirements-based approach. But today, we want a more robust and detailed assessment using straightforward language in the questions. So we select the questions-based option. After clicking the Step 2 bar, we choose the Universal Questions and the NERC-SIP standard. This gives us a comprehensive set of questions, including everything found in the NERC standard. We then move to Step 3 to determine our Security Assurance Level, or SAL. The level is used to determine which questions are displayed in the question set. The lower SAL levels require less rigor for the organization. We consider using the general SAL, which is consequence-based. However, we decide to use the NIST-based approach for determining our SAL. We understand the NIST process, and so we go directly to the information types and select the ones that apply to our facility. We finish the process by reviewing the final questions in Step 3. We have determined that the answers are no. Based on the NIST approach and preset values, we are moderate in all categories, and thus the overall SAL is moderate as well. We click OK and then move to the diagram. We close the Symbols docking window and load the pre-installed PCS template. We could also have imported a diagram from the Microsoft Visio application. We then customize the diagram to reflect our facility and networks. When the diagram is complete, we check the basic network analysis and find some problem areas that will need to be addressed. With the standards selected and the diagram complete, we will now answer questions. Answering the questions will take several hours, so we plan our day accordingly. As a team, we review each question and determine if we are meeting the question's intent. Some questions we need more information on, and so we open the information window. We also notice that we can open the source document for a question and even find additional supporting reference files. For every question, we can add comments, mark it for later review, attach supporting documents, and enter an explanation for questions marked as using an alternate approach, as shown here. Common questions for components can be answered as a group using default questions. However, an answer can be changed for a type or a single device. Now that we have answered all the questions, we can check to see how we are doing. We notice in all areas that we are just above 40%. We can see how we scored, broken out by both components and standards. We also notice our top areas of concern and where we need to focus our resources. To get even more detail, we click on the chart and drill down to see a new window. We then drill down again in a specific area to see how we answered each question. We can get additional detail in other areas as well, including a summary of results by component type. The final step is to print the reports. We review the results and update the executive summary, and then select the report options. We choose the output format, which in our case is DOCX, and print the reports. All the charts from the analysis screen and a list of missed questions in ranked order are included. With the report, we now know what we need to work on. To help us understand and resolve each concern, we go to the resource library to find a treasure trove of additional information. With this help, we can now start the process of becoming a much more secure facility. Before closing this tutorial, there is another feature we should introduce. It's the ability to work with multiple assessments. This is called aggregation. By selecting Trend, you can examine several assessments of the same facility completed over a period of time. Compare lets you examine the assessments from several facilities. The Merge function allows you to combine several partial assessment files into a single complete assessment. We will look at each of these in more detail. First, add the files to be used. Simply click the Add Assessments button and select the desired files. The alias is simply a short name used to identify the assessments in the analysis charts. The assessment labeled Default will be considered the primary or baseline assessment. Assessment compatibility refers to the percentage of similar standards and questions among the added assessments, not the consistency of the answers selected for the assessment questions. Clicking the Information tab allows you to add description information about the aggregation. This information will be included in the aggregation analysis reports. Select Trend when you have performed several assessments of the same facility over a period of time and want to examine changes to your security posture. Click the Summary Analytics tab to see the results. A printed report may also be created. Use the Compare function if, for example, your facility consists of several small sites that each have their own assessment. Comparing them allows you to see the strengths and weaknesses of each, as well as an overall compliance summary. The Merge feature should be used to combine several assessments into a single one. This would be helpful if your assessment team assigned groups of CSET questions to different team members. Each of their partial assessment files could be combined into a coherent whole for that facility. If some questions were left blank, or if the same question was answered differently in different assessments, the differences should be resolved before proceeding. To do this, go to the Merge Differences tab. The table shows those questions needing review. Simply click the answer you would like to use. To save time, the answers from the default assessments are preloaded into the table. Unlike Trend and Compare, Merge creates a new assessment file rather than a report. Once saved, it can be opened in CSET, modified, or used to generate reports just like any other assessment. This tutorial has provided a brief overview of the main features available in CSET. See the topic-specific tutorials or the user guide for more detailed information.